A woman who blamed gambling for ripping off the company where she was working was back in court just weeks after a WLKY investigation found her still gambling. Linda Ireland was convicted of stealing $340,000. WLKY Steve Bergen joins us with the latest on this case. Steve?
Vicki, Kentech Machinery, a father and son operated business off Fern Valley Road, was financially devastated after discovering a trusted employee had been embezzling their money. Based on new information about Linda Ireland, they were seeking an increase in restitution.
This is Commonwealth versus Linda Ireland, 09 CR 2956.
Linda Ireland appeared again before the judge who sentenced her to 120 days in jail in June of 2010 and ordered her to pay restitution of $250 a month. But what he forgot to tell her was not to gamble. A WLKY investigation found her doing just that on February 1st at an Oklahoma bingo hall. At sentencing, with members of Gamblers Anonymous behind her, attorney James Moore said Ireland had changed her ways.
Those were faces of 20-plus compulsive gamblers who were in the rooms with Linda, who were there last week to celebrate her one-year anniversary from gambling.
We were receiving calls from members of the community saying, we know she swindled this money and we just watched her drop $1,000 at a bingo parlor.
Moore says that's a fabrication, that Ireland only gets a small salary from the rags to riches consignment shop. He also claims she lost one job in part because of WLKY.
Since she was fired because of the news story, and obviously because of her actions, I mean, I'm not trying to minimize what she's done. She's received $100 a week from that business.
Judge Mitch Perry refused to increase restitution, but placed more stringent guidelines on her probation.
I'll amend the judgment, conviction, sentence, probation to specifically include you're not to gamble.
Yes, sir.
Cam Blinko is with the company Ireland ripped off.
At least he did set, finally, at least something that I thought should have been done in the first place was no gambling. So I guess that's one thing we've accomplished, if we've accomplished anything. Hopefully she'll live up to that.
The judge gave Ireland's probation officer more leeway to arrest her if she violates the conditions of her release. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.